Let's practice curve sketching using information from the first derivative. Okay, so here's the directions. Sketch a function that is continuous on negative infinity to infinity and satisfies the following conditions. So the first condition, the first derivative is greater than 0 on the intervals that are listed there. The first derivative is less than 0 on the interval listed. F prime of 1 is undefined, so the derivative is undefined at x equals 1. And at x equals 5 and x equals 8, the first derivative is equal 0. Okay, so this is all just information about the first derivative. And we're going to use that to sketch a function. Now, just from this information, there are several possible functions that you could sketch. And I'll kind of show you that when we actually sketch it. But we can still know a lot of information about the function just from this information. We can know where it's increasing or decreasing, maybe where it has maximums and minimums. So probably the best step to start out with is to take this information and kind of summarize it in a number line. And then from our number line, we'll attempt to graph the function. Okay, so let's set up a number line and then summarize all this information on it. Okay, so I'm going to have my x values here. And we see kind of just from reading the problems that are, there's some x values that are important. Like 1, 5, and 8 look like there are important points here. So I'm going to make special note of those on the number line. So let's put 1 there, 2, 3, 5. And 8. Okay, and then it keeps going. Okay, and then what we can do is we can put now information about the derivative. Okay, so let's start with criteria 1 and see what this is telling us. So the first criteria is telling us that f prime of x is positive on these following intervals. Okay, so on negative infinity to 1, so let me kind of divide up my number line there at 1, and then I can write over here that f prime of x is greater than 0 on this interval. Okay, what else? From 5 to 8, okay, so let me splice this up again. So from 5 to 8, f prime of x is also greater than 0 there. And then also from 8 to infinity. Okay, so f prime of x greater than 0. Okay, so what about the second criteria? F prime of x is less than 0 on 1 to 5. Okay, so 1 to 5, f prime of x less than 0. Okay, so as you can see, I'm just kind of breaking down this information and putting it on a number line. Right now, we haven't really interpreted the information yet. We're just laying it all out. Okay, so what's the third point? F prime of 1 is undefined. Okay, so f prime of 1 is undefined. So maybe right here I'll just write undefined, f prime of 1, and f prime of 5 equals 0, and f prime of 8 equals 0. Okay, so this is all the information we know about the first derivative. But now let's take this information and translate it into facts about the behavior of the original function. So let me make maybe a new line below where there's room, and this is going to be behavior of f, behavior of the function f. Okay, so let's start with the positive negative information, like what does it mean for the derivative to be greater than 0? Well, the derivative being greater than 0, of course, means that the derivative is positive. Okay, so if the derivative is positive, what does that tell me about the original function on that interval? Well, it tells me that the original function is increasing. Okay, so on this interval then, f is increasing. And then that's going to be true over here from 5 to 8 as well. Okay, but what about this place where f prime of x is less than 0? Okay, well that tells me that f prime of x is negative, which tells me the original function is decreasing. Okay, so let me write that in a different color. So here, f is decreasing. Okay, so that's some good stuff. But let's translate these other pieces of information. So I know that f prime of 1 is undefined, and I notated that on my number line. But what does that tell me about the behavior of the original function? Okay, so remember that when the derivative is undefined, that means, if the function is continuous, it means that at that point, I must have a sharp turn. So either a cusp or a corner, some sort of sharp turn. Okay, so let me try and squeeze that in here. So at this point, we have a corner or cusp. Okay, and what about 5 and 8? So what does it mean that the derivative equals 0 at those points? Okay, well, the derivative equaling 0, what that tells me about the original function is that I have a horizontal tangent line at those points. Okay, so here and at 8 as well, we have horizontal tangent lines. Okay, so now we have kind of a summary of the behavior of f. So we want to take this information and actually try and graph the function. Okay, so here's my graph here. And you'll see that below it, I've kind of taken the information on our number line above and just kind of consolidated it so that we can directly compare what we know about f prime of x while we're drawing a graph. So basically what I've included on this sort of smaller number line is the sign of the derivative, whether it's positive or negative, and then what we know about those special points 1, 5, and 8. Okay, so we know that until we get to 1, our derivative is positive, which tells me that the function is increasing. And then when we actually get to 1, we said before, the fact that it does not exist means I'm going to have some sort of sharp cusp or corner. And then after that, you'll see that the derivative is negative, right? So that's a local maximum. So just from this information, we don't really know exactly where the points are as far as y values. So we just draw them wherever we want. So I'm going to make my cusp here. It's at x equals 1. That's the important part. And I know I'm increasing until I get to that point. And then I know I have a really sharp turn, and then I start decreasing. So something like that. In the, you know, it might be shifted up or down, but it has this general shape. Okay, so what's next? Well, we know we're going to decrease until we get to x equals 5, and then we're going to increase again. Okay, so that tells me x equals 5 is a local minimum. So let me just sketch that on here somewhere. So I'll put it here. Okay. So I want to make that a local minimum, and I want it to be smooth this time, right? Because I have a horizontal tangent line there. Okay, so something nice and smooth like that. Okay, so now I've changed to increasing again. Okay, so then what happens? This one's a little bit different, right? So I know that I have a horizontal tangent line at x equals 8 because the derivative is 0 there, but I don't change from increasing to decreasing, right? I stay increasing. Okay, so I need to incorporate that horizontal tangent line while still increasing. Okay, and that happens at 8. So let's see. I'll put it maybe right there. Okay, so that's going to then look something like this. We kind of want to flatten out there at 8 and then but keep increasing. Okay, so not a perfect graph. This is just a sketch. But this hopefully gives you some sort of idea of how to approach these problems. So you just want to be really organized with your information, make a number line, and then translate the information about the derivative into the behavior of the original graph.